Welcome. I've created a series of open channel flow animations that I'd like to share with you. This animation is one in a series of videos I've made that examines how normal depth varies with several different channel or flow properties. Here we examine the role of channel width on a steep reach. Before we go any further, let's examine the four different subplots that you see on your screen. This upper right subplot is a cross-sectional view of the channel itself. The red dashed line is critical depth. Actual depth is shown by the blue patch on the screen. In the upper left, we have three quantities shown, and you'll see that as the channel gets wider over the course of the animation, these quantities will vary. The quantities shown are the normal depth, the hydraulic radius, and the Froude number. You'll note that the Froude number is something slightly greater than 1.5. That number will stay greater than 1 over the course of the entire simulation. So this entire simulation or this entire animation is taking place in supercritical conditions. In the lower left screen, we're showing, again, versus channel width. We're showing various depth ranges that correspond to the S1, S2, and S3 ranges. So these are the depth range from minimum to maximum where an S1, S2, or S3 curve could reside in terms of actual depth. Finally, we're showing in the lower right the energy depth relationship or EY relationship, and specifically shown are normal depth, alternate depth, and conjugate depth. Normal depth, you can see, is on the supercritical branch, and vertical to that is the alternate depth, and then slightly less than that is the conjugate depth. The horizontal distance that separates the normal depth from the conjugate depth would be a reflection of the energy loss should a hydraulic jump take place from normal depth to that conjugate. Okay, let's watch this animation unfold. I'm going to let it play, oh, I don't know, about halfway through, and then let's see what we can see. You can see that the channel is getting wider as the animation takes place. We're at about 25 feet of width right now, so let me pause it there. And you can see that the Froude number is staying more or less fixed. The normal and hydraulic radius are both diminishing as the animation plays out. You can see that the channel is actually wider, so the discharge per unit width, since discharge is actually constant, the discharge per width is going to get smaller as the channel gets wider. Therefore, the EY diagram is going to shift because the specific discharge, the discharge per unit width, is diminishing. These three depths are going to then track to match the EY diagram that corresponds to the current specific discharge. The relative positions of these three depths really isn't going to change much over the course of the animation, but the absolute position will change simply because the EY diagram is slowly migrating leftwards as the specific discharge gets smaller. Finally, the S1, S2, and S3 curves are all playing out more or less in parallel with one another, all diminishing as the channel gets wider and wider. I would invite you to look at my other video that is examining normal depth as it varies with channel width on a mild reach. Many similarities here, the big difference being, of course, the Froude number here is greater than 1. In that other animation, it's less than 1. Let's let this animation play through to completion so you can see how this all plays out. Relative positions all stay basically the same. The absolute magnitudes obviously are going to change as the channel is getting wider. We're at about 40 feet now, on our way to 50 feet wide. Okay, so I believe we've reached the end of our video at that point, or the end of our animation. I just have a few words I'd like to share with you. Again, I'd like to encourage you to look for the other animation that corresponds to changing width, normal depth with changing width on a mild reach. And otherwise, I thank you for your attention, for your interest in this video, and I invite you to enter any questions or comments you have in the comment area below. Also, you can click in the link to the description of this video for information about my book and about details about this video and others that illustrate other concepts from my book.